Good evening. Welcome. We're so glad that you decided to join us tonight. Thank you for being here. Thank you, parents, for allowing your child to participate in Kids Jam. If you're visiting tonight for the first time, I'm Sarah Akins. I'm the Director of Children's Ministries. But I cannot take credit for all of this. We have very talented people within our church that contribute to our children's ministry. Ashley Wren is the choir coordinator, and she created this scene for tonight, and she directs the first through fifth grade, and Lainey Harris directs the pre-K and kindergarten choir. But they are combined tonight. They'll perform together tonight, and they're super anxious, super excited, ready to get in here. So I'll try to be quick, but I do have a few announcements. The angel tree you may have seen as you came in. If you ate here, I know you saw it. It's towards the back doors out here as you come in. Just wanted to make the announcement that it's the last chance to participate in that. Those gifts are due on Sunday. If you're not familiar with the Angel Tree, it's a ministry that we do each Christmas. It's for the prison ministry. Children who might have a parent in prison, that parent wants them to have a gift. And so you take an angel off the tree and you buy that gift. And it's given to the child from the parent. So it's just the way that you can give back at Christmas. So Angel Tree, last chance to do that. Also, following the program, we're going to have refreshments, some Christmas treats for the kids, and that's in this back corner here, so hang around if you don't mind and let them participate in that. Thank you, Cameron, up there doing our light and sound, and Reed. They do a great job. I want to make sure I thank them. And tonight, the Lone Manger. It's a lot of fun. It's a Wild West Christmas adventure. It takes place in a small western town called Incarnation. So with that, we'll get started.
Dusty. I prospect and climb the hills up north from here. Pardon my dust. born and raised here in Incarnation, a town that celebrates Christmas, may be better than any town in the West. Hear that train whistle, sounds of change. Suppose that's why you're here, to see the first train arrive in Incarnation. Big doings, but this is 1891, for goodness sake. We've become modern.
Well, here they come, our first visitors. Incarnation's been here for near 100 years, and the very first train is about to arrive at our new station.
Took the railroads long to push through Incarnation, Sheriff, but whoever gets off that train, I hope they need a haircut.
Announcing the arrival of the very first Christmas Express special, inbound from Kansas City, Wichita, and parts east, arriving on track one.
What's that contraption you've got on your shoulder, ma'am?
This chair is called a camera. It captures images of things.
These take actual pictures of folk?
Sure do. I've come to Incarnation to document your Christmas celebration. Thank goodness for the train. Hey, can I get a picture of y'all? Say cheese.
Sheriff, anything about what's happened today bother you?
Why would it, Ellie?
I'm afraid of the criminal element coming in on the train. Strangers, outsiders, bandits.
I even hear that lonesome stranger is loose.
Now just hold your horses. Last thing I need are you three getting all worked up about something that ain't never gonna happen.
What if it does?
Don't have time to talk. I got too much going on already. I'm greeting our new school marm and choir director.
She's on this train?
Sure is, and there she is. It sure is good to meet you in person, Miss Polly.
And it's certainly good to meet you, Sheriff Smith. I've heard so much about your wonderful, very meaningful Christmases here in Incarnation. So intimate and quaint. I'm so excited.
Well, you can't be half as excited as we are to have you. Sally here is our postmaster. I'm sure she'd be glad to help you with the things.
Sure thing, Sheriff. Come on, Miss Polly. Follow me.
You see, that's what I was afraid of.
What?
Are you deaf? Didn't you hear her say quaint?
Sure did. What does quaint mean?
It means charming and old-fashioned. Miss Polly from the big city, Wichita Falls, the big time. We're smaller taters to her.
We're not small taters. We got that new bandstand in Town Square.
Is it a better idea than when we dress up cows and sheep for the Christmas Eve service? It's not a bandstand, it's called a gazebo.
We gotta come up with an idea that'll impress everyone this Christmas. An idea that'll be amazing.
Like what?
I don't know, put your minds together. We gotta make this Christmas the best one yet. Modern, big, think.
I'm thinking, but nothing's happening.
Make a life-size angel out of iron. We can hang in the church.
With what? Anchor chain?
Best idea is forming.
What's your idea?
It'll put us on the map. It'll make history.
Is it a better idea than when we dress up cows and sheep for the Christmas Eve service?
Of course! That was a disaster!
Only because of a tiny mistake.
Tiny? You accidentally dressed up the bulls instead of the cows, then let them loose in the chapel.
Tell me that wasn't unforgettable.
Huh? What are you getting at, Curly?
I'll create the Star of Bethlehem with the electric light. Ooh. And I can build it.
Amazing. Just wondering, Sheriff. I mean, we always had good Christmas celebrations before, but now that other people are in town, we didn't need to change things. Can't we just be ourselves?
She's got a point, fellas.
Sally, I know you're the chairman of the Incarnation Christmas Committee, but let me explain. They're used to bigger things than what we've got. We don't want to seem small and get laughed at.
There's nothing small about the creator of a world becoming a man. After all, that's what our town means. God becoming man, I'd say that's plenty big.
Thanks for your thoughts, Sally, but I believe we done decided.
Well, that's one problem solved, but what are we going to do about the bandits?
Seriously? Again?
Mrs. Sneef is right, you know. For all we know, that train is fixin' to bring a peck of trouble into Incarnation. Might even rob her store or my blacksmith shop.
Heavens! Now, Ellie, you're all as jumpy as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs.
You might should be a little nervous of yourself, Sheriff. I hear that lonesome strangers in these parts.
I can't have all three of you wrapped up trying to find a bandit. Well, don't even. Wait. No, I've got it. I've got a secret and dangerous mission for you hombres.
What is it? Tell us.
I'm deputizing the three of you as my posse to apprehend that sidewinder, the lonesome stranger, if he tries to get into Incarnation.
You won't regret this, Sheriff.
We won't fail you, Sheriff.
It's all true what I've heard about Incarnation. You have the most wonderful Christmas decorations, but this year I'd like to add to that a very special piece for the Christmas Eve service, and it's coming all the way from Dodge City. It's a very special manger made by my great, great, great grandfather, and passed through the generations in the family.
Well, it ain't no electric star, I can tell you right now.
This manger's over 200 years old, Sheriff. It's the oldest Christmas decoration in the West, and this year, it'll be right here in the town of Incarnation.
Very nice.
Very old. I still say this Christmas we need something modern.
I think this Christmas we need more of what people always need. More hope, more love, more joy.
And that's what I hope this manger will remind us of. We need more Jesus.
Oh, come, oh, come, Emmanuel. Captive Israel that mourns in love.
Oh, come desire nations by, all peoples in one heart and mind. Bid envy, strife, and quarrel cease, fill the whole world with heaven's peace.
Took a bit and gout. Boy, a lot's happened in the last 2 weeks. She has that first choir ready for the first demonstration. Oh, and the big news is that Miss Polly's manger arrived just minutes ago on the afternoon train.
Deputy, you better look at this. Winnie, the telegraph operator, just handed it to me. She just got the message and wrote it out longhand.
What is this, Egyptian hieroglyphics?
No, it's just the telegraph operator's handwriting. She used to be a doctor, you know.
I can't make heads nor tails of it.
Well, if I'm reading this right, it looks like Dodge City warned us that the lonesome stranger came in on the afternoon train today.
Deputy, I think I saw that outlaw get off the afternoon train the other day. Big black hat with a wide brim, big mustache, and he had a long black coat.
Okay, then. You better keep your eyes out. Now, I don't want the town panicking. So, let's just keep it between us, okay?
Got it.
As we all know, Christmas is 2 weeks away, and this year is the 150th anniversary of Handel's famous piece, The Messiah. We have worked very hard on a version of the Hallelujah Chorus from that remarkable work.
Oh, good. Now we've gone from 200 years ago to 150. At least we're moving in the right direction.
I just wish my father, Parson Whitfield, was here to see this. He was pastor at Dodge City Church until last year when he went to a better place. My daddy wanted to be here today, but obviously, God had other plans. Well, we're ready for our first performance, and all we need is for some musical accompaniment.
As chairperson of the Incarnation Christmas Committee, it gives me a great pleasure to open our Christmas service and welcome guests for the very first time. Well, Miss Polly, we're the simple folk, not like the professionals you worked with back in the East. We don't got no violins, harpsichord, fork, harpo trumpets.
All we got are guitars and fiddles.
That's all we need.
In the stillness, the earth is asleep. Stars light up the sky. Lonely shepherds, a flock of sheep, another silent night. Slide it explodes with amazing force. Good news comes blazing forth. angel brilliance breaks the night, but do not be afraid. The shepherd's hillside, bathed in light, as night becomes like day.
Glory to God in the highest rings, the heavenly chorus on angel wings.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I bring you good news, great joy. Today our Savior is born. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
To us a son is born. For unto us a son is given. And he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace.
You're making more noise than a cat fight.
There you are. Hope we got that trap set right. If the lonesome stranger goes for the bait, we got him.
For sure. That net'll fall on him, and if it does, we'll hear that bell ring.
We got the lonesome stranger, for real this time. Now, Mr. Lonesome Stranger, it's time to find out what you look like.
Hey, she's the spitting image of the sheriff, ain't she?
She is the sheriff, Bane. What'd you use for bait, Mrs. Sneef?
I done used the slice of my warm apple pie.
Wait, are you telling me that the sheriff is a lonesome stranger? How could you, Sheriff?
No, you galoot. It means we ambushed the wrong person. What'd you use for bait, Mrs. Sneef?
I used a slice of my warm apple pie.
I got it for a snack, and doggone if I hadn't smelled that warm apple pie.
Can I get a photo of the capture of the lonesome stranger?
But I'm not the lone.
Say cheese.
What's going on here?
Well, I might as well tell you now, we do have a reason to believe that the lonesome stranger has snuck into Incarnation.
Now don't panic. We don't know if that's true or not.
I got a telegram.
Don't you see what's going on here? We're all getting wrapped up in things that really don't matter to our celebration of Christmas. Listen, people, Christmas is about Jesus in the manger, not being modern or catching some bad guy we haven't even seen.
Sally's right. That's why God sent Jesus, so we don't have to live in fear. Remember the first thing that the angels had to say to the shepherds? Fear not.
So God don't want us to be afraid of desperados?
That's not the point, Ellie. The point is that in God's town, we're all desperados. We were separated from God. We were hiding from God. Except that in God's town, nobody's good. Everybody's a desperado.
Long time ago, we was on a trail split from God's trail. Since then, we chose to go our own way. Since then, we're the outsiders. We're the outlaws.
Imagine us catching a lonesome stranger and someone comes up and says, I'll go to jail for him.
Oh, psh, who'd love an outlaw?
Jesus would. He came into our world as a baby so we didn't have to be separated from God no more.
Shepherds watched their flocks by night. A little baby was born. While the star in the sky was shining bright, a little baby was born.
Deputy, we caught these.
I got a package for Miss Curly.
What you doing just sitting in your shop, Curly? Arise, shine, for your light bulbs have come.
I can't believe it. There's no time to waste.
Deputy, we caught these outlaws on the afternoon train today.
Desperados.
Bandits for sure.
Don't look much like bandits to me.
Well, they ain't. They're three cowpokes and they ain't from around here and they're wearing big black hats.
Howdy, y'all.
They don't look like much desperados to me, Ellie.
Well, don't be fooled. Remember the black hats?
Are we in time?
For what? To rob us?
No, to go to your Christmas celebration.
The Star of Bethlehem?
Just what in the world is going on here?
And maybe the lonesome strangers gang, Sheriff. The posse caught the yellow bellies trying to sneak into town.
Say cheese. Who wants copies? We're not in anybody's gang, Sheriff.
We just came in from the east because of what we read in the newspaper.
Well, east tests us at least. We traversed afar. Just wanted to see how Incarnation celebrates Jesus at Christmas.
Field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star.
The Star of Bethlehem?
Nah, the Kansas City Star was a newspaper that printed train schedules on page 3.
Y'all see this? You're all hammers and tongs about catching some strangers in your town. And you caught 3 guys just wanting to celebrate the birth of Jesus.
Doesn't that remind anybody of anything?
No, not really, no, no, no.
The wise men! God showed them how to find his Messiah, and they left what they were doing and followed.
So when Jesus was born, God made sure that even people far off like the wise men could come and worship Jesus. Looks like God is still bringing people far off.
Wise men travel, saddled on their camels, ready for a long ride. No matter how far, follow that star, lightning to light, leading to the true light.
Your light's come, shining in the darkness. Your light's come to all the world. Go tell everyone, the star tonight is big and bright. Your light.
Carry through the desert 3 nice presents, gold, frankincense, myrrh. What we bring is only fit for the king to celebrate the holy birth.
Glory to all the earth.
Attention, everyone. As chairperson of the Incarnation Christmas Committee, it gives me a great pleasure to open our Christmas service and welcome guests for the very first time.
Oh.
stranger.
We've got the lonesome stranger, for real this time.
Oh, no.
No, Sheriff, this time it's the right one. He's the hombre I saw getting off the afternoon train the other day.
Well, where'd you catch him?
Right where you think he'd be, stealing Miss Polly's 200-year-old manger.
Oh, no. Caught him red-handed, stealing a priceless relic.
Did he seem to be cleaning the dust off the manger?
Yep, but he was gonna steal it after, for sure.
That was my father.
Your father?
You said your father passed away.
No, I didn't.
You said he went to a better place.
He did. He retired to Florida. You ever been to Dodge City? Trust me, Florida's a better place.
But y'all also said that he wanted to be here, but God had other plans.
Well, he said he was gonna try and make the first train, but he wasn't on it, so I decided he wasn't gonna come. He just missed the train, came 2 weeks later and surprised me.
So the mysterious man at the train station?
Is my father, Parson Whitfield, who passed the manger down to me.
Well, Ellie, why don't y'all take that blanket off of Parson Whitfield?
Pleasure to meet y'all. Sorry if my daughter Polly here caused y'all any confusion.
Daddy just wanted to see your faces when you first saw the manger.
You know, I bet this would be the perfect time to start the nativity pageant.
Absolutely, ladies and gentlemen. And the angel said unto them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all of the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God on the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son. And if we believe in him, we will have life everlasting. Life everlasting.
Thank you.
waiting for. Thank you so much for all your support in honor of Incarnation and Christmas celebration. I give you the Star of Bethlehem.
Look around you, Curly. Have you ever seen so many people worshiping Jesus at Christmas? This is absolutely the best one yet.
Sing all ye bright hosts of heaven above. Glory to God, all glory in the highest.
Oh, come let us adore him. Oh, come let us adore him. Oh, come let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Oh, come let us adore him.
Thank you.
Jackson.
Chase Jackson. Angel. Ben Harrison Angel. John Morgan Shepherd. Jack Cummings Angel. Mariella Angel.
Hello.
Gus Cummings. Wayne Avery Shepherd. I am Franklin Angel. Skylar Aikens Angel. Jack Howard Shepherd. Madeline Aaron Angel. Elizabeth Aguirre Angel.
Charlie P. Shepherd.
Caroline Toussaint, Savannah Gordon,
Claire Colton,
Leah Kate Henry,
Townsperson,
Lane Aaron, Townsperson,
Meredith Mathis, Townsperson,
Kevin Hendricks, Townsperson.
Susanna Hayes Polk, Townsperson and Soloist.
Lorelei Prosser, Townsperson and Soloist.
Salem Allen, Townsperson and Soloist.
Sophia Penn, Townsperson and Soloist.
Macy Chester, Cowgirl.
Emma Hildy, Townsperson and Soloist.
Sydney Kate Aaron, Townsperson and Soloist.
Sam Hubbard, Townsperson.
Davis Harrison, Townsperson.
Cole Murphy, Cowpulk. Merry Christmas, y'all!
Caroline Mathis, Townsperson and Soloist.
Elizabeth Lane, Townsperson.
Addie Hodges, Mary Ann Soloist.
Anna Case Harrison, Townsperson and Soloist.
William Polk, Porter and Solos.
Ike Covered, Joseph.
Corey Hildy, Capok and Solos.
Allie Powell, Station Master and Soloist.
Bailey Harrison, Capok and Solos.
Peyton Coulter, Miss Polly and Soloist.
Ella Claire Jackson, Photographer.
Carson Bickery, Jane and Soloist.
Olivia Wren,
Curly the Barber and Soloist.
Kendall Reagan, Sally the Postmaster and Soloist.
Will James, Deputy.
Eva Beth James, Mrs. Neef.
Evan Averett, Parson Whitfield.
Abby Smith, Sheriff and...
Seriously, again? Soloist.
Lydia Lippincott, Blacksmith.
Drew Prosser, Dusty / Narrator.